grip on your menstrual. I'm sorry if this sounds vengeful, but the fact is, I'm gonna hit you with lead, and it won't be the pencil. I kind of stumbled, you know, I put the little gunplay words, and I don't like doing that rap, though. I don't like mentioning, like thug shit, gun shit, like that, because, you know, I'm a fucking gangster.
Yeah.
Fucking corny white boy that lives in the fucking mountain, eh?
It's more intellectual.
That's more problem. Yeah, exactly. Well, I mean, I've been fucking with guns my whole life, and I'd put gunplay in it, but it's not me, you know? I want it to be my true persona, not a fake persona, you know?
Yeah.
What makes Eminem so good? You don't fucking start spouting off about how he fucking took cats and he talks about smacking others. he sticks to what he knows, you know? He doesn't go over that borderline.
Yeah.
Well, actually, there was pretty good stuff on Facebook. I'm just typing it down.
I'll listen to some more if you got some.
This one's alright. This is kind of like off the top. Still coming up from the bottom, aiming for the top. When I get behind Mike Kors, that's when it drops. On these clowns with no stop. Beef is just an appetizer to the shit I drop. I used to not give a fuck until something in my life popped. I was on all four trying to find a safe spot. Until you cowards left me to rot. That's when I realized I need to take better care of my crops. Props that were ripped rotten from the core because of the pills and drugs I popped. Didn't realize the people I was hurting.
It's about
all I'm saying.
Your ratio win loss is fine.
I didn't realize the people I was hurting from around my spot. Now I'm on a better day without worrying about the cops. Now all I do is make sure that I'm right and staying on.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Quiet, in other words, stop. Fucking with my way of living, you may end up feeling hot lead. And I ain't talking about.
I believe that pretty much shits on your mom's face.
Fucking with my way of living, you may end up feeling hot lead. That will give anybody hot spots.
Sorry,
I said that's too much shit right there. But, you know, something needs to be fixed up. But, like, I go on to say, I'm not no gangster, but I have been around the block. And I know it's not fun. And I know it's not a fun spot. To go through this type of shit, you must be, you know, go through this type of shit before you realize what's hot and what's not.
Right.
Oh, I'm sorry, that's kind of weak.
No, it's good, man. I like it.
It's good wordplay, but it's not. There's too much wording in it, you know? It's like, you take out those if. That's what you don't want to do in your act. You want it to be
flow.
You want it to be verbal. You don't want it to be, you want it to be, always like an action. You don't want it to be, like, describing something in a sense, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Here's a good ad. This is my favorite one. This is fucking around. This is like, fuck, what can I do? I'm bored. And I'm like, yeah, from this first thing I wrote in a long fucking time, dude. A couple years. Living in a life where sin wins. While I'm pulling grenades and throwing the pins. This how it goes. This how it ends. Hell nah. I'm here for the cause. I stand out, cussing out, spitting venom from my jaws. I guess it takes some pain, but all in the end, I would do it all over again, except the bullshit I put my mama through. You never know the damage that it causes through and through. Now it's a new day, where life starts over with new days. New things come our way. With new things, we have new things to say. Unless you're talking about those that write you off, thinking that you're nothing because they have it all. Or they're just clowns always flapping at the jaws. But the truth is, people think, and some people shouldn't think at all. Hang with fake bitches, you might as well go ahead and pray for your downfall. All in all, we need those people that want us to fall. Beat up their hate and drop bombs on them like a shock and awe. Oh, I know that'll sting. What I say is what I mean. Tired of always walking in the grass, but the fucking grass isn't green. I treat haters like a pair of acid-washed jeans that get thrown out with the rest of the small beans. And fuck no, I ain't drunk. I ain't had a sip over 2 months. 2 months of my life, I've been drunk off pain. Off of phonies that for different things they've said. No, I ain't painting a picture, I'm installing a fucking image in your head. 16 bars and I still have so much to be said, but I think you get the picture of the pain that comes through my head. The things that make you wish you were dead, things that make you wish sometimes
beats, or are you going to hire a producer?
I don't know. I don't know. Sometimes it's really good for fun, really, but I've had people's opinions on like, dude, it's alright. Some people are like, nah, dude, you can really do it if you wanted to. And, you know, that's just mixed opinions, but I really do it for just the love of it. Because I like writing. Like, my biggest thing is I like to write poetry. You know, rap was just something I experimented with after me and Allison broke up.
Aw, man. And, guys.
Church Grove Road. I was fucking just pissed, dude. Like, I
fucking saw a car in the driveway that punched the fucking window on that shit. I better not do that. But anyway, she come pulling, like, driving up in her van and shit. And she's like, get the fuck in here. I'm like, oh, fuck you. Blah, 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 blah. And I finally get in the van. I was like, you stay me the fuck home. I was like, fuck this bullshit. I was like, oh, I ain't fucking talking to you anymore. She's like, you hold on, let me explain myself. I was like, I think you already have this fucking piece of paper all over my hand. But first off, you shouldn't be going through my shit. I was like, first off, I was like, you want to talk about honesty and shit? I was like, that's not real fucking honest, you know? I was like, why can't you just come forward and tell me that? I was like, you could have told me that, I'd have been cool about it. I was like, I'd have probably been a lot cooler than what I am right now.
Yeah.
But, that subsided, and I fucking got, I kind of ruined everything between us, but I guess somehow I tried to make it work, but it never did. And I ended up moving to Myrtle Beach. And she come down there to see me at Myrtle Beach, and then Justin was looking with some gay black guy. Your trail. We called him Gay Trail. I think he's dead now. That's weird. Anyway. She came down there, and was getting ready to go out one night. I'm sitting in my room, I'm laying in the bed. I don't know what I was doing something. And, her phone started ringing, and I was like, I looked to see who it was. It was kind of being, I guess it was being nosy. But then I looked at it, and I didn't recognize the number. I didn't answer, because I didn't fucking, I was like, man, it'll be like that. I'm going to fucking answer. So, there's the voicemail. And it leaves a message, and I'm like, oh, well, fuck it, I'll listen to the voice message, because she'll never know.
Yeah.
I'll just fucking listen to it and have the phone up.
Yeah.
I listen to it, and it's this fucking douchebag. She worked with the Brennels. Man, I was fucking talking all this sweet shit to her on the fucking voice message. I'm like, who the fuck is this douchebag? His name's Ryan Blankenship. No, not Ryan Blankenship. Ryan, what was his last name? Ryan Bono. That's his name. Ryan fucking Bono. And, I listened to it. I just kept to myself. We was at Broadway at the beach about, 3 or 4 hours later, and I was like, I said something to her, I was like, you hang out with anybody up the mountain anymore? I was like, you talk to anybody? And I was like, what do you do way up there? She's like, no, I just go to work and go home. I was like, that's cool. I was like, why don't you hang out with anybody? So I just don't have time, da-da-da. I was thinking of all these bullshit stories, but in the back of my head, I knew she was fucking cheating on me. Well, this fucking dude.
Yeah.
Like, another part of what even pissed me off was, like, 3 weeks before she came down there, I was like, you consider us still together? And she was like, yeah. She was like, I consider us still together.
Wow.
I was like, well, it's kind of working. It was kind of working, too, because it wasn't like we was all up in each other's shit all the time. We weren't fucking arguing. Kind of legit. I was kind of trying to better myself. I was, clean from drugs. Before then, I was doing smoking pot, drinking with children. And, finally, I don't know. There's a lot of bullshit that went on with that place we lived at. Justin, like, the fucking dude that we were staying with, that black guy.
Yeah.
He charged me and Justin, the first 2 weeks of there, he charged us a month's rent. And that was only for 2 weeks. And after those 2 weeks, he's turned around and charging us another $500.
Why?
I'm like, how the fuck is that possible? I don't know. I'm like, dude, we paid you a month's rent. We're good for a month. He's trying to fuck me and Justin. And Justin, I don't think Justin realized that at all. Like, I think he finally did it eventually. But, I don't think I was talking. I didn't really feel a whole piece of at the time, man. I was going through fucking bad withdrawal of fucking uppers. And it just wasn't the right time for me to be down there. Plus going through all the bullshit battles. And so I decided to go back to Mount Airy with her. When she was going back, and we just sent the car going back to fucking Mount Airy, and she said something just off the fucking wall about, like, something, I don't know, Justin said something about some girls came over to the place one night, and there's girls he knew. I didn't fucking have anything to do with it, because I was at fucking work. She fucking brought that up, I was cheating on her and shit, and I didn't. I've never cheated on her in my life.
Yeah.
About did one night. I about fucking did, but I didn't.
Yeah.
But, that fucking pissed me off. Her pretty much accused me of cheating on her. sudden, oh, you're good. All of a sudden, I snapped and I sprang up the shit. Like, who the fuck is Ryan Bono? Or I know what Bono, I didn't know his last name at the time. I was like, who the fuck is Ryan? He's like, what the fuck? How do you know about Ryan? Like, I got my ways. I ain't fucking stupid.
I gotta ask him.
He's like, well, what you know, all he does is get me weak. Like, oh, that's all it is, huh?
Said that,
I kind of cooled down, yeah, things shut down, shut down. Biggest mistake was ever going back with her, honestly.
After that, backed out,
accepted his invite, and I'll get back to my area, sit with her up there for about 2 weeks, and me and my buddy, I know, up there, Joe Clinton.
But I have to change the background, I can't use
fucking start playing. I hate that shitload of that fucking ANT ass bullshit from Atticus. I was like, fuck it, I'm leaving that area again. So I left to go to Wilmington with Joe. We're going to try to move down there. Take all that ass and sell it. And fucking just get a place down there. And so one night I call Allison and I can't get my hold of her. And I remember that dude's number for some reason. Some reason I remembered his fucking number and I called his number. I was like, yeah, I called him up and he answered, hey, what's up, Ryan? I was like, by any chance, is Allison over there? He's like, no. He's like, she'll be over here in a little bit. Oh, yeah. I was like, really? I'm like, tell her boyfriend called her. He's like, her boyfriend? I was like, yeah, her boyfriend. She's like, wait. He's like, wait. I thought I was her boyfriend. I'm like,
holy shit.
Fuck no. Dude, I fucking snapped. I fucking, like, Joe left me with all that fucking acid, which wasn't really a lot left. I fucking, you know, Justin and him were fucking passed out from drinking. I had all this fucking acid of his, and I fucking dropped about 10 hits at one time.
Yeah.
I just fucking sit on Justin's mom's little balcony, fucking pissed, just trying to fucking not break something. Justin's mom's apartment. Just freaking out, dude. Like a Brad type freak out, man. Like nothing personal with Brad, but yeah, like, freaking out bad. And that's pretty much the end of me and Allison. I think I ended up fucking her a couple more times. But, you know, after that, I was pretty much said and done. It's kind of a long breakup, to be honest with you.
Man, she's cold-blooded.
I was just fucking good to that girl, man. Not once did I ever fucking charge her rent.
Why was she like that?
Honestly, I told you, man. Yeah, I mean, I wasn't. At that time, I wasn't sharp as a tool in the shit, man. I was doing fucking any drugs, man.
No, I mean, why was she like that?
Well, I'm trying to explain why. I mean, I don't think it was like her personally trying to hurt me. I mean, it was, well, I guess maybe in a sense it was, but I don't know. It's just being young, man. I guess I fucking didn't tell you, bro. Only she knows. And like I said, I mean, I guess she didn't feel like she was going to get anywhere with you, man. Like fucking weighing out her options and playing the field again. But that's the only thing I could get from it, you know?
Nuts.
Where the fuck'd you go? You not playing?
No, it booted me out. Disconnected me from the server.
But, that's all good, man. I had a solid, I ain't gonna say a friendship with her, but I talked to her on Facebook, you know, it's kind of kind of cool, man, because, I mean, it's like, that sharp, intense pain, like, I did love her, man. It took me a while to get over it, man. I mean, when I was down and out, and people weren't fucking wanting to help me, and people were fucking writing me off, and fucking pretty much considering me a fucking off card somewhere, you know, when she looked inside me and saw somebody different than what people saw of me, man. That to me is, that meant the world to me, man. And not to mention that, you know, I'm probably gonna marry her, man, if I'd have straightened my act up, dude. If I'd have straightened my act up and got my fucking driver's license and fucking tried to get to school, fucking, you know, I don't think it was the jobs I worked for. I mean, I worked two fucking jobs while I dated her. I worked two jobs for like 3 years, dude. But the thing about me at the time was just fucking buying meth every day, fucking at 6 o'clock in the morning, fucking tweaking out my fucking skull. I mean, she was doing it with me there for a while, and she was doing it with me a lot.
Yeah.
But I think she just got tired of the fact that she was doing it with me. And then I guess she felt like I was the core problem of why she can't get her life. That eventually fall where she was coming from. You know, she was fucking, right when we broke up, she was 25, 26.
Yeah.
Yeah, 25, 26, something like that. You know, she fucking wasn't doing anything in real life. She was working at Brentles, fucking driving a shitty fucking van. She should have been in school, fucking, and she should have been going to a university. But on the other hand, I mean, that's not my fault she wasn't doing that, but, I guess she felt like she had to fucking change something. I mean, I don't hate her for it. I don't even hate her for the abortion thing anymore. I kind of somewhat feel like it's
crazy,
not somewhat a good thing.
Was it one abortion or two abortions you did?
Just one for me. I mean, I don't even remember. I've always pulled out, man. I think I was just scared of coming to girl, man. I can't even believe I did it with her, you know?
Yeah.
Honestly. How fucking drunk I must have been, I guess. I used to get fucking drunk with her, man. I get us both a little pint of Remy Martin cognac. Fucking, we fucking take shots of that shit. Pop Vikings and smoke weed. Blue View Motel.
God.
Good old days. I hate fucking her. Goddamn. I know everybody in that fucking hotel heard this. I wouldn't be surprised if there was somebody jerking off next door. I gotta say this though, man. That was probably the craziest ride of my life. And then Portland came, man. That's probably the second craziest ride I've had in a while. I just can't wait for the next one. Hopefully it's a good one too. You know? Before I enter a ride to jail or being in Mount Airy, man, you never know. You can't tell in Mount Airy, man.
Yeah.
I don't know. I guess another thing is kind of weird, man. It's kind of hard for me to get back into a relationship with another, like a girl nowadays, because I don't like that Russian chick. You reminded me of Allison in a sense. She liked me for who I was, regardless of what I had, you know. I do this anniversary, but she fucking listen to this shit. Up to work, like, but no, she didn't work that day. I took a cab to work, like, 12 o'clock in the afternoon. She was off. She worked at a beach shop for a Jewish guy down there. And, my apartment was wrecked, dude. Like, fucking dishes piled up, laundry not done, fucking floor had some sort of crud in it, and then vacuumed in like 2 weeks. My ass was a wreck, dude. This fucking chick, dude. I come home, I had laundry cleaned, my clothes folded in the closet, dishes are done, bathrooms clean, the living room looks like it was just, you know, somebody just moved in, like right, you know, you get ready to move in. The fucking whole apartment. It didn't even look like my apartment. I was like, that fucking right apartment? I didn't think I did at first. I was like, really? What the fuck happened? She had fucking dinner made. That's a fucking chick right there.
He's going
through the menu. Then I got some hard stuff. Patrick and I have married this bitch. Unfortunately, she had to go back to Russia.
She's a fucking cunt.
What's she doing again?
Calhoun.
Oh, I figured out.
Blue
icon.
I think you would be good to move to Portland.
Oh, I plan on it. That's why I'm not. You don't want to move back to Myrtle Beach, dude. I mean, even Justin didn't want to move back to Myrtle Beach. I think the only reason he did is he felt like, I mean, that's. It is. Out of Mount Airy.
Well, he didn't have much of a choice. I mean, he was living in Maryland and Sacramento, California, and then Maryland, I decided Maryland was going to come out here with me, and I guess...
He could have stayed, I think, but I don't think he wanted to, because he didn't know nobody, like, around.
Yes, yeah.
Like he does me, you in Maryland, so... that would be
about that, and I just came up there and like took Marilyn away. But, well,
yeah, but she went on her. That's the way life goes, man.
Yeah.
I can't say it that way, but it does. You know. Kind of sucks, man. But you know, I always thought that you guys wouldn't even fucking talk to each other anymore because of you know the whole thing in Marilyn. I told Justin, like, you know, I was like, dude, I was like, things happen for a reason, man. I was like, you know, you just can't dwell on it, bro. I think he's gotten over it, honestly. I don't, you know, I can't say for sure, but.
I hope he has. I mean, he needs to.
I think he has. Yeah, I think he has. I mean,
that's.
When he first moved back to Myrtle Beach after living in Portland, he's fucking, he was devastated, dude. Like, I don't mean to put his business up there, and I ain't talking shit about him at all, man. Drunk, man, and just fucking sit there and listen to music. It was like, it wasn't the same Justin I knew before he went up there.
Yeah.
I could tell he was sad. I mean, I think he felt bad for the thing that happened when he was out there the first time.
Yeah.
I think more or less he was kind of, I think he was a little upset at himself of the things, the way things worked out between you and him. I know you know what happened, and I don't have to go into detail about it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I think he felt more bad about that than the fact that you and Marilyn were together. I think when he came to grips with reality on that, he was like, what the fuck was I doing? And he even explained to me out in Portland, like, thoroughly, like, what happened. I'm like, damn, you know, like, shit happens, man. It was like, you know. And I was like, don't dwell on it so much that it's going to fucking eat you up all your whole life.
Yeah.
Like, dude, you know, I got in fights with him. I know fucking. He said there's one night in Myrtle Beach. I'm like, what the fuck are we having a fight for? But, probably rent. It's always been rent. But, they're both fucking heavily drunk. Fucking fucked up to him, man. I was like, dude, fuck this bullshit. Let's fucking go, man. I'm tired of this. Da-da-da. Like, I don't even fucking think about that shit, you know? It didn't affect my relationship, friendship, man.
Yeah.
You know, friends get in fights, man. That's what happens.
Yeah, I mean, I've been friends with him after that. I was friends with him, like, the day, like, 3 days after that. I mean, I've never, I didn't know what he was doing. He was drunk, but I just wish he handled himself better.
The problem with alcohol, man, alcohol's a bitch, man, so I don't drink anymore. Like, I drink once in a while, I socially drink, now. I don't drink to get buzz. I get drunk. My dad helped me realize that ever since, too. Dad's a fucking major alcoholic, or he was. He's not, he's been on the sharpest tool in the shed now. I don't want to be like that.
That's what confuses me. I mean, you've known Justin for since fucking high school. I don't understand why you'd be so bent out of shape over fucking $20.
I don't know. I mean,
it makes me think there's something underlying, like something else is making him. Something else. I don't know, man. I don't know what he's thinking.
Like, what do you mean?
Well, I don't know what it would be, but it seems like, why would $20 make somebody act that way? Is there something else going on?
Well, I don't know. I mean, probably that $20, I mean, I would think so. I don't own any other money. I did get in an argument with him out there in Portland. Or, well, not in Portland, but, when I was in Kansas, when they sent me a message on Facebook one night saying that I need to send him money to send out to Portland, I'm like, dude, wait a minute, hold up. Dude, I fucking paid that much rent. I gave you all my shit to fucking sell so you can have money to at least get back with. Like, you really honestly believe, you think I'm gonna send you money to fucking fix that? I'm like, dude, I paid you 1 month's rent. We had one more month to pay. I was like, honestly, if you wanted to, you know, I thought it was going to work out like this, maybe that second to last month that I took care of, you know, I didn't stay out there for that last month. I mean, I was on the lease, but I paid that 1 month, so I figured, you know, he could take care of that last month, and that way it just caught even, you know?
Yeah.
He wouldn't owe me money, he wouldn't have to, you know, pay me, you know, the fucking money he owes me back, and, you know, it's fucking just, I don't know, man. Fucking pissed me off. I mean, he asked me at the wrong fucking time, question in wrong time, really. But I know it like a fucking heated argument where, you know, I was like, actually, I don't really remember the argument, so I don't know what was said. But I know there wasn't nothing like too harsh in it. I just remember telling him, like, look, dude, you owe me fucking money, man. Like, I don't understand why, you know, where you come off that I still should be able to have to send you money to send out to Portland. Like, it makes no sense. Plus, I was kind of pissed off at the time, too, a little bit. You know, I don't know what little deal him and Marilyn had out, but she was staying there. I mean, I don't know how that, you know, what he owed her or what, you know, what he was trying to, you know, do for her. But, you know, I felt like, in a sense, you know, that was just as much as my apartment as his apartment. So I felt like maybe, you know, Marilyn could have helped him out while he was still out there. But, you know, he finally fucking told me, you know, to deal on that. So I kind of saw that and I was like, well, I understand that.
Right.
I mean, there for like a month, man. I was fucking buying food, I fucking bought them cigarettes all the time, fucking made that rent, fucking smoked weed with him, fucking. Man, there was nothing else. There was nothing left else I could do for him, man. I was just like, hey, dude, what else do you want me to do? Do you want me to fucking? This is what I did, man. I'm not putting myself on a pedestal.
No,
this
I know
is what I did, man. I mean, the whole month's rent, so me, him, and Marilyn could have a place to stay. Then all the stuff that I could not take with me, I gave to him to let him sell on Craigslist, which he sold all of it, I think. I mean, he got money out of it. I think he made like $200 or $300 off all that shit.
Like Austin pads and stuff?
He still had stuff he sold, but, dude, I gave him a fucking nice TV. I gave him my desk, movies, video games. There's a couple other things I don't remember off the bat, but, you know, and I felt like, and I didn't do it expecting anything in return, you know, I'm not that type of person. I told him whenever I moved out to Kansas, and we was talking one night on the phone, he's like, dude, I owe you so much money. I was like, dude, just take care of yourself, man. I'm like, I know you'll get it to me one day. Yeah. I'm not sweating that right now. But just take care of yourself and get yourself in a position, and if you feel like you gotta pay me back, man. I was like, cool with the whole situation, man. I didn't fucking call him up every day, dude, what's up with the money?
Well, I have same thing going on with Brad. I gave Brad, like, when I came out there last month, you know, it's more close. I gave him like probably $100 and he kept telling me, I'll pay you back tomorrow, I'll send it to you cash, I'll send it to you, what's your meaning, man? I didn't question him, I wasn't like a dick about it, I wasn't like, you need to pay me this back. I was like, okay, man, here's $20, like, here's $20, next day, here's $20, because I happen to have some money, man, in my deposit. I said, okay, man, September 3rd, I'll pay you back, what's your meaning? And, I didn't question him, and said, make sure you pay me back or anything like that. I was just like, okay, man, it's cool.
It's money, man. I mean, fuck it. It's everywhere. Yeah. I mean, right. I know, you know, money's going to come to me. You know, it's not a big deal. You know, fucking, I'd rather have a friendship than lose a friendship over fucking something stupid like that. You know, just to fuck my girlfriend, it might be a different story. money, not such a big deal because it's, you can't take it when you die, you know. But it's not a personal thing, you know. I mean, I had somebody at work today, like, somebody owes you $650, would you be on them, would you be hounding them? Like, fuck yeah, dude, I'd be knocking on their goddamn door every fucking day. I'm like, damn. But really? So why? Well, you get $650. I'm like, dude, it's just money. I'm like, dude, you're a bitch, you don't go get your money. I'm like, dude, not the way I'm looking at it, man. Like, I'm not a bitch because I'm not gonna go get my money. I'm like, it makes no fucking sense. No, like, they said, well, obviously you don't like money or something. I'm like, no, I don't like money. That's why I come to work every day.
Right.
You know, I wish I could work for free. I hope the message is sent, Justin. I kind of hope it, you know, just squashes the shit, man. I don't, truthfully, man, I mean, I'd hate to lose Justin as a friend, man. I hope what he said back to me in Portland, I'm not sure, man. Like, we won't speak for, you know, 20 years. I don't fuck, dude. I'm not gonna fuck out of Justin. Justin's the one friend of my life. Ever since I moved back from Joy Ranch back in 94, till now, he's the only friend that I've had that doesn't fucking judge me on stupid shit. You know, he doesn't look on the outside. He just looks at what's in the inside. And that's what I love about Justin. You know, he's fucking, I think it changed over the years, but
he doesn't have like that in high school. Unique perspective. Nobody else I've ever met has. He has a weird way of observing things, observing people.
I wish you could drink it, man.
Yeah, I know.
I feel so much better nowadays when I don't drink. Like, every time I used to drink, man, I was just... What crap, man. Oh, I feel like crap.
I thought about getting a six-pack tonight, and I was like, why? It's just going to make you feel like shit. Every time you do it, it makes you feel like shit. Fuck it.
Six-pack. I mean, that's alright, but that's not that bad. But I see your point. I mean, it was like, really, what's the point?
Yeah, what's the point? Yeah, that's what I mean. It's like, why? Drink it and then why? Something. I mean, why? I don't know. It doesn't do anything for me.
Like, the only time I'll ever drink is when I go out. Like, if I go out to the bar, normally, nowadays, I'm just next to rare, man. Like, I've been out two or three times since I've been back, man, and one night I got pretty good buzz one night because everybody kept buying me fucking drinks.
You go to the back street or anything like that?
Nah, there's this bar up there on 52, with that pool hall, like right there in front of the DMV, that stoplight, it's called Legends Bar.
Yeah.
Pretty cool, that's alright. It's like a fucking high school reunion every time I go there, right? Huh. Just, that's kind of the biggest turn off for it. I don't like seeing the people I see up there. Yeah, but man, I'm fucking fucking up for me. I don't know what's fucking right, man.
Yeah, I've never liked it. I might have liked it, but I never liked what it does to people.
Now, I'm bad on alcohol. If I drink alcohol, I get no bad mood. I'm a fucking belligerent asshole, dude. I don't give a fuck what I say. I'll say the most hurtful thing to you, and I don't even fucking care.
Right.
But I sober up at least. I'm like, what the fuck? I just say that shit for you. But, that's what I don't like about alcohol, man. It turns me into a different person. I'm not an asshole.
So what happens when you and Justin both get drunk?
That's not good, but both of us being that way. Doesn't work. I play better with the sound off on this game. It's crazy. Honestly, dude, I ain't trying to be a dick when I say this, man. Quit assuming I'm ignoring you, man. I'm not ignoring you. If I'm not talking to you, it's for a good reason. It's probably because either A, I'm having a bad day, like today, or I'm just busy, man.
Alright. I didn't mean to act like your girlfriend.
John. I didn't know you probably got it. I didn't want to say it like, I didn't want to say it all asshole or something like that. My girlfriend just like that.
No, I was just...
I don't think I know you that well to fucking...
It was just weird because like, I invited you to the party and you like joined and you're talking and you disappeared.
Well, no, the reason I joined is the reason I left is I didn't want to fucking be a Debbie Downer. I was in a bad mood. I started playing that game. The people we were playing with, I mean, I don't think they were really paying attention to the game. And, like, two of the guys I was playing with, they just run past the enemy soldiers. And there's the enemy soldiers shooting and killing me. And like, I'm like, fuck it. Let's go back out and press me some more regret. I'm already in a bad mood. So I just backed out, man. It was just for the better part. Cause I didn't want to piss nobody off. And I didn't want to fucking break my bad juju back on y'all. Y'all feel like shit. Or, you know, I just didn't want it to
because of the fucking Paul Jones.
This is that, man. That's just a lot of shit, dude. That's, I mean, fuck, man. It's just everyday problems, man. Fucking, I don't make no money tonight. I gotta fucking make a car payment here soon. Just a lot of shit, dude. I mean, fucking house. I mean, I'm gonna come home to this house, man. Like, you find one thing wrong, and then you turn around and find something else wrong. This is the fact I'm 28, living back here at my mom's house, man. There's just a lot of shit, man. Much shit's on my mind that I think about, man.
What made you decide to all of a sudden move out there from Kansas? I mean, you told me that. You told me your dad was acting like he wanted to hang out with you and stuff. I remember that.
Well, yeah, well, I mean, most of the reason is that, I mean, my family out there, it was like, dude, I fucking never did anything with them, man. They never invited me to do anything, and I did. It was always something, like, always something stupid to do, like, help them do stuff. And I was like, that didn't bother me as much, but whenever, you know, I invite my dad over for dinner to my apartment, and you know, I just surprisingly cook, like, steaks or something, and fucking mashed potatoes, and a fucking good meal. And I was like, yeah, I get dad over here, I'll have a meal, fucking shooting shit, watch a movie or something. And then he's just fucking like, I can't do it tonight. And next week, I try to do something again. Because maybe that time, I can't do it. I get tired of it. My sister's always fucking being a fucking drama queen. Fucking douchebag, I just fucking take the air. Just a fucking douchebag. It was a fucking, just so negative out there, man. Coming from Portland, where I was just making positive all the time.
Yeah.
Didn't fucking, I just got tired of it, man. A lot of fucking strain on my fucking mind. I was trying to do my best to make the whole family thing work.
Yeah.
And it didn't seem like I was getting the same effort on the other end, you know. And then I knew my little brother wanted to go to California.
Texas 12.
You know, all that. I want to see him at least 4 weeks, so that's one reason. Yeah, my mom, she's here by herself. She's got my buddy. That's my dog. I mean, there's lots of reasons. But I always got to remember the decision I made. I can't regret it now. I don't regret it. It's just sometimes
it gets boring. Were you brought up in the house? Like when you were the child going to elementary school?
Okay, dude. Me and Justin used to sit upstairs and smoke fucking wood blunts, play chess.
What elementary school did you go to? White Plains?
Nah, it was Arrington, just right up the road from
me. Oh, yeah.
Right here on the south.
And then you went to, because I went to Flat Rock, and I went to Gentry, and then I went to North Surrey. And you went to Therrington, and
Mount Airy Junior High, before it got demolished, like, before the middle school. Came about, and then I went to high school.
It's just weird how in like a small town like Mount Airy, there's two different sets of people. One set went to the North Surrey, one set went to the Mount Airy. It's like, it's weird.
Well, I mean, it's big enough to where you can have two school systems. I mean, there's a little over 6,000 people live there, man. Mm-hmm. I didn't even know that. I thought it was less than that. I just thought it was like 3,000 people live there, but looked it up a couple months ago. Population, man.
So you grew up, were you raised by your mom and your dad, or your mom and
your stepmom? I didn't know my dad. I knew of my dad. You know, I mean, he was there for a little bit, but I don't have, like, vivid memories of it, you know? Yeah. But, that all came about while I was out in Portland. I was dead asleep one morning in my bed and made a phone call. I didn't recognize the number, but I answered it anyway for some reason. I was like, hello? That's your killer? Yep. Yeah. You want to speak to me? My name is Karen Kelly. And she's like, is this Patrick Kelly, William Patrick Bill Kelly? I'm like, yeah. She's like, oh yeah, I'm your sister.
Huh.
I'm like, what? I'm like, sister? I was like, I don't even know I had a sister. Like, yeah, I'm out here in Kansas, da da da. Like, 2 days later, I fucking live. I'm smart, didn't really do too much work. Oh, yeah, happy birthday. And then he cuts me short and talking to him, which is not surprising.
Wow.
I made it 26, 27 years without him. For sure, I managed the rest of my life without him.
Yeah, definitely.
And my stepmom showed more interest in me than my dad did. My stepmom thought the world of me. I've never had anybody in my life, like, parental figure. Say the things she said about me. Like, I remember sitting up with her late at night, just conversing with her, and she just fucking said the greatest thing, like, great things. Like, the most amazing things ever you could say to somebody. Now, I'm a pretty good judge of character, whether somebody says something, if it's genuine or not. Pretty genuine about it now. Like, she actually calls me from time to time, but I always miss her calls because she calls me on her work. Straight enough.
Yeah.
But I guess they felt like the only grade teacher came to my house and told my mom I was crying about 10 pounds. Like, she made it such a big deal. My grandma, she was a bitch. She had a lot of influence on me going away, too. She didn't like me.
Your grandma didn't like you?
I was a middle child, man. Black sheep, man. Black sheep from the day I was born, man.
That's fucked up. My grandparents didn't like you.
My grandparents didn't like my dad. They didn't like the fact that my mom married him. I guess where I was the offspring of him. Because they figured I was just going to be the same way. But, you know, in honesty, man, from a lot of psychology books I've read, what the stuff they've done to me in the past is really a core reason why what the things I went through in the later years, you know, the rebellion part, drug part.
Yeah, I just realized that my mic wasn't plugged.
I don't think if I ever got sent away, I don't think I'd ever, you know. I was a good kid, man. I didn't have a role model, let's put it that way. My older brother wasn't a good role model.
That's funny.
I don't think at the time, you know.
I know, I'm just glad he's still around. This could actually be the fucking Fuck My Life website, though.
Yeah. But it would fucking help, you know. But. A lot of the stuff I read, though, it made me distant from my family, man. I felt like when I turned 13 and I started really thinking about why I got sent away. I'm just kind of thinking, you know, being able to consciously think about the whole thing and put it into perspective, it maybe resembles a lot more, you know?
Yeah. When you finally left, you could see it from the outside.
And another thing, too, I mean, my older brother and my little brother's always been my favorites. And I've always been, like, the outcast, so to speak. And the truth is, I probably have more common sense than both of them put together. I'm smarter than both of them.
Fucking completion.
Like, if you were to put us three out in the wilderness and told all three of us, you know, do what you gotta do to survive, I guarantee I'd be the last one that wouldn't survive.
Right.
They don't have that mentality.
It sounds like you've been shit on your whole fucking life, man.
Even if I didn't go through all that shit, they just don't have common sense, dude. They really don't. They're intelligent as hell. I mean, my little brother, I mean, he's a smart dude, man. I mean, he can grasp things quicker. Like, not like, you know, like a book smart type of intelligent. He can grasp it a lot easier than my older brother. My older brother is just, he has no common sense, but he has this, like, sense of, like, the hardship, like, he was taking pre-calculus in 10th grade, dude. I don't know what it is, but it's crazy. Like, he had no, like, he really believes the clouds don't move, dude. He's a fucking computer scientist. And he told me one day at lunch, when we think now,
in the house, y'all.
3 or 4 years ago on Mother's Day, he told me, we were talking about the weather, and I was like, yeah, the clouds are moving in. He said, the clouds don't move.
What?
Are you serious? Like, clouds don't move? Are you really, did you just tell me that? Seriously?
He's
like, they don't. He's like, the earth rotates around the clouds. No, so I don't even know what he said. It was so stupid. I was like, dude, you're an idiot.
What the fuck? I've never heard that theory.
I told him, I was like, do you get a bachelor's degree in science? And you really think the clouds don't move? Wow. I'm sorry for you.
That's like 14th century science.
No, dude. He even was convicted on it. That's how much that he was sure the clouds don't move. He was pretty convicted, dude. Like, honestly, I even joke with him nowadays about, yeah, I think those clouds are sitting still.
does he still think that, or has he come to terms?
I think he may come to terms, but I think he's not going to be the bigger man and fucking admit it, though.
Nuts.
It's like, too, my little brother, I think my little brother takes after me a little bit, in a sense, like, the only thing that me and my little brother have in common is that we're blood. We are from the same mother, we're from the same father. We connect totally different than he does with my older brother and I do with my older brother. My older brother has a different dad than both of us.
Yeah.
into learning things from other people. You know what I'm saying? Like, he won't admit it to this day, but he didn't learn how to write from me. I mean, he might have learned how to write structurally better than I do in the school, but if I had never started writing, he would have never started writing. So I think he picks up things after me, and he holds it dearly to him, too, and that's what I love about him. He's down to earth. He's his brain in a sense, but sometimes he just doesn't have any fucking common sense, though, for real. Like, he's out in California right now, staying with my cousin. My cousin's Filipino, and I'm pretty sure my cousin hates every family member in his family. He probably hates his dad, honestly. And I don't know, something happened up there where him and my little brother got in an argument, and then they kind of de-escalated. Then the roommate in the States, my cousin, has been staying with him forever, told Eric, or he told Eric that he said that somehow he's a faggot and he never amounts to shit in life. I don't think that he said it. I think it's just the dude starting shit. You know how people are, man. They'll just make up shit and say shit just to get shit started, you know?
Yeah.
And some old brother goes, you know, this is very common sense. My old brother doesn't come in. He's in California where he doesn't have a place to live other than my cousin's house. And he just gets drunk and starts fucking calling my cousin out. Fucking flapping at the jaws. Fucking just trying to be tough. Fucking make liquid courage, man. Fucking bitch. And, he threatened to kick him out. I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know, but I guess they might have settled their differences or whatnot, but it's just, he's be smarter. He's fucking 3,000, almost 4,000 miles away from home. It's a place that he's not familiar with, in a sense.
Yeah.
So fucking just be grateful he's there and fucking ride it out, man. It's like me going out to Portland and staying with Justin, and then, you know, it's fucking, all of a sudden, they're calling him out all the fucking time, or, you know, just fucking,
well, Justin
you
know, said
biting the hand.
Justin said that in Kansas, and I might have the story wrong, one of your brothers stole some pills from your dad or something, like the first day?
No, he didn't steal the pills from my dad. My dad was giving them pills, my brother. He's a pill addict. Like, he fucking snorts pills. Like, I'm talking about, like, hardcore pills. Oxys.
Yeah.
Roxys. Shit like that. And he came up there. I don't know. Apparently, he didn't steal them. Apparently, my sister did. So she changed her story, so I don't know what to believe. But, the whole pill thing. Like, they should have known better. I mean, I fucking told them before he came out there to see him. But please, I knew they were taking pills. Like, please don't give him pills. But he's already died off. My dad didn't even fucking listen to him. He didn't even think. I don't even think it fucking went to his skull, honestly.
Right.
Not that I care that you know that. Like, it doesn't bother you, you know, but I kind of wish Justin would air that dirty air. I mean, I told him in that confidence. I don't tell nobody that, because I don't want people to think, nah, it's all good. I mean, at least he told you and I. With this fucking stranger. Because you can't take all the boundary out of people.
Yeah.
Even I got a little bit of boundary in me.
I don't know how you
stand out about it. I'm not mad about it. There's something I told Justin. Confidence, dude. You know. Thought good though. Every year or 2 years ago, it don't matter. It's not, but the way my sister's made it out at the time, too, like, she stole, like, all their Vicodins and fucking Ambien and shit. Come to find out, my other sister, Andy, was giving them to him. I said, what the fuck are you giving a pill out of pills?
Well, I don't know, Patrick. He's like,
you really need it because you just met his dad. I mean, bullshit, shut up. It's like you're a fucking nurse. Ain't no better than you give some pill addict pills. It's like you're just feeding his addiction more and more.
Yeah.
Kind of pissed me off. That kind of made me resent him a little bit for that because I don't like seeing how they're all fucked up on pills. Man. That shit hurts me, man. I fucking been there. Man. I've been there, done that.
Yeah.
Not as bad as he's on, but I just don't want to see go down that road. Fucking OD or die, man. I don't want to do for him, really die, man. I mean, really, if that comes down to it, he's really all I got in this world.
Is he still addicted to pills?
I don't think so, man. I've seen pictures on Facebook. It looks like, you know, he's been on some weight. I mean, I could be wrong. I don't know. I hope I'm wrong, but he's not.
Right.
Yeah, I just hope he's not. You know what I'm saying? I don't think he is, but he never can fool people.
Yeah, people relapse too.
Plus, in California, man, there's worse shit than pills if you run about up there.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know what I'd do if I lost my little brother, man.
So you're going to ask your mom to fucking move to Portland, or what, you're going to leave again? No, are you going to ask your mom to move to Portland if you did move to Portland?
Oh, she won't move. Nah, she won't move to Portland. I'm just kind of here for now. My older brother has this plan. Like, he's got to get a bigger house. The house he's living in. It's kind of small. It's not small, man. It's like a fucking nice house. I wish I had it, but he wants to get a bigger house, and then he wants my mom to move in with him. And I don't, you know, that could be a year, 2 years, 3 years from now. But I just don't want my mom sitting in this house in her Mount Airy for that, just by herself all the time. I mean, I'm still here, and she don't really do a whole lot, man. She just sits on Facebook, man. She's retired. I fucking try to get her to get out and do shit, but there's not too much you can do around here, but, if I wasn't here, dude, I don't know. Plus, another reason, dude, I've never had a great relationship with her, man.
You said she was mad all the time when she was raising you.
Well, I mean, she had reasons, dude. I've done my share of bullshit, but, I don't care, I'll tell you, I think I've already told you about me hanging out with those guys and whatnot. Well, they broke into my mom's house, stole my mom's TV, stole my mom's VCR, whatever it was at the time. But I fucking took the fall for it. Like, they were trying to get me to do it. I was like, what the fuck? Break into my own house? Like, I can just walk in and get the key and take it. I was like, but I'm not going to do it. I was like, I know I'm fucking addicted to fucking coke and meth and shit, but I'm not doing that.
When was this?
If you don't do it, we're going to do it. 2002, 2003.
Right.
But, yeah, they pretty much like, well, if you ain't going to do it, we're going to do it. And I fucking really believe these guys. I knew they would do it, and they did. Only thing I could do is just get my little brother out of the house and fuck him up or something. And these people just hanging out, man. They're fucked up people, man. But, I mean, it's kind of my fault. I'm thinking that way, you know. So I can't fucking sit here and play pity pat catcher and say, well, it wasn't my fault. But all this, there's other shit. Like, if you fucking broke into a building and took the fall for that. And I took a lot of fucking fall for them. And then they don't have fucking audacity to bring me money while I'm in jail or fucking come by and visit me or anything. Friends, right? It's like that rap song I sent you to you earlier. That was that whole situation, pretty much.
It's so fucked up.
Shit, I put my mama through. I never knew what it would do through and through. All these motherfuckers sit here and let me write. A lot of shit I write is directed to this baggage, man.
Who were they?
Paul Green and I never knew who the other guys was, man. They call him Bird. story, though. I knew the guy that Paul used to work with. He was a pretty cool guy. Like, you know, he wasn't really drunk. He just worked for Paul. Apparently, when I was back in L.A. just recently, I saw him at Walmart. And I don't know, some reason I just brought his hand. I was like, what the fuck is that faggot up to now? That's Paul. Like, oh, you didn't even hear? I was like, what happened? He said, he went to New York and he tried to rob the wrong person and got shot in the fucking face.
Really?
He fucking killed him. Yeah. I was like, wow, I ain't karma, bitch.
Wow.
I don't know how true that is. I mean, I guess...
Yeah.
I don't want to imagine this guy was just making a story and watching it like that. Something like that.
I remember Justin's mom throwing the fucking, throwing a drink on you or something for no fucking reason.
Yeah, me and Jerry. Yeah, you, Brad, and Allison, and Justin was. I came over, y'all were supposed to come back or something. Let's smoke some weed or do something. I don't know. And I ended up coming over there to Justin's house. Sherry was there, and she was like, we can hang out with me until they get back. I was like, alright, so I hang out with you. She's like, hey, you know, she was watching football, drinking some vodka. And that time, Justin's mom didn't like me for some reason. I don't know why. Never done anything to her.
She's crazy.
Helped her move her shit. I don't know, I helped her move her shit like 4 months before that so she could move to Myrtle Beach. And fucking heavy shit, like, ridiculous shit. Didn't even get paid for it. And I'm sitting up there with Sherry. Or no, before I come in, she's like, I don't want him in the house. And Sherry's like, shut up, Mom. He's just hanging out with me upstairs. And I go upstairs and I ask Sherry, I'm like, is it cold, man? I was like, I ain't really trying to start any drama. I ain't trying to get shit started. And the whole time, Justin's mom's just down there fucking doing the talking shit about me. I'm like, I really can't handle this, Sherry. He's like, I just want to leave. She's like, don't leave, don't pay any attention to her, she's drunk. Alright, whatever. So I start drinking with Sherry, and like 5 minutes later, here comes fucking Justin's mom upstairs, like, trying to get me to leave and shit. I was getting ready to leave, and I was like, fuck it, I'll leave, whatever. And she just fucking picks up the pitcher of Kool-Aid and throws it on me.
Damn.
It's fucking brand new fucking Quicksilver shirt I just bought that day. A fucking pair of khakis I had on, a pair of brand new white shoes I just bought. Fucking boy, I was pissed. Fucking Sherry was like, oh shit. And I fucking just, I kinda got pushed the fucking wall and I was like, I don't fucking escalate anymore. And like, I just sit upstairs and I just sit there and I just started laughing at fucking Terry. Like, I'm just fucking, like, what the fuck? Like, who does shit like that? And I go downstairs and I'm trying to leave and I fucking look at fucking Terry and think, you're a fucking dumb bitch. I don't even know why fucking Justin and Sherry like you. Like, honestly, like, that's bullshit. Like, who does that? Who throws Kool-Aid on somebody? I let her have it, dude. He's like, you better get the fuck out of here. I'll call the cops on you. I was like, yeah, for what? I was like, what are you going to call the cops on me for, Terry? Funny thing is, I guess she still likes me, I don't know. But she ended up fucking liking me for some reason. Kind of like two-faced, though, I thought.
That's crazy. I mean, if his mom was like that, imagine what it was like growing up in that house. And Jimmy, your dad. I like Jimmy, though.
Jimmy, my God. Jimmy, dude, he used to fucking... God, they just used to fuck with Jimmy hard. Completely fucked, drunk, and... Like, he's kind of really fucking dude. That's fucking hilarious. Probably Jimmy, too. Jimmy's a good guy. He doesn't mean any harm to anything. He just wants to get drunk, that's all.
Yeah.
But I feel bad for him in a sense, because... Like, I don't think anybody really tried to help him, like, quit drinking. You know? They just keep feeding him alcohol. Like, here,
yeah.
Drink this beer and shut up, Jimmy.
Yeah.
Like, dude, the people you love, you really do that for the people you love? I'm probably don't do that.
What happened?
But whatever. I don't think it worked. Man, seriously, that's more pissed off than that. I had fucking Kool-Aid on, my brand new clothes and shoes.
You know, that's so
shit ain't gonna come out either. I know, look, fucking shoes I had, I still shirt, I love that shirt. It's a fucking yellow Quicksilver shirt. And I didn't save my money up for like 2 weeks to fucking buy that shirt and shoot this motherfucker. The day I buy it, Terry's gonna fucking let us go home.
Haha.
And it's like, you know, at that time, I'm like, what's that? Like, where are you out of jail? I was in jail. I was 4 months in jail for all that shit. I don't think I knew Allison before.
How'd you meet Allison?
Once at Sonic.
Oh, yeah.
I can't remember, dude. I think that was after you. Yeah, I was living in Midland, too. Remember that day I paid my fucking rent, too? I paid my rent, and I had a little extra money to buy those shoes and that shirt. I fucking walked all the way up to Stationport on 601 just to buy those shoes and that shirt. And fucking, I was so proud of myself because, you know, I was like, that's what I want to fucking work in jail and fucking do dumb shit.
Yeah.
Full goal and got my goal accomplished and fucking paid my rent.
She fucking threw Kool-Aid on me, man. It's so fucked up.
It's not even Kool-Aid, red Kool-Aid.
Oh my god.
Look, the thing is that sherry. Like,
how pissed were you, man? I mean, I can't imagine the anger.
Dude, I punched a hole in the fucking wall. I put a fucking TV off the thing, but I'm like, I'm out of my place. I'm not supposed to keep me going out. I gotta really check myself quick. After it all happened and I was leaving, Harry is back downstairs sitting in her chair and gets bladed into her, dude. I was so pissed. I was like, no wonder Justin doesn't like you.
Justin doesn't like her?
Well, I just said that to be despiteful. Make her think, oh man, my son doesn't like me.
Yeah.
Trying to be like I was just like, fuck, man, it's kind of fucked up thing to say, you know? Your son doesn't even like you. I was just trying to think of the most hurtful thing I could say. I was like, hey, come up with it. I'm sure Justin likes her. I hope. His mom. Oh, hurry, he wouldn't be in this pool. So. Oh, that's all cool. I made a joke about it with Myrtle Beach. I walked into our apartment in Ivysville. It's funny. Justin moved back from Portland to Myrtle Beach, and I just moved back to Myrtle Beach. I moved back to Mount Airy for a while. I did some probation time because I had a little bit of suspended sentence from all that shit.
Yeah.
And I was trying to just get away without being on probation. I moved into the same apartment complex that Justin's mom and dad lived in. I woke up and I went on my balcony and I was smoking a cigarette and I still had sleep too. And I looked down and I see an MA hat and this guy looked just like Jimmy walking his dog. And I was like, man, that is fucking Jimmy. And I was like, Jimmy. Jimmy Grimes. But who is that? It's TK, man. He's like, oh, what are you doing here, man? What is here, man? Yeah, we do too. He's like, Justin and Terry, we got an apartment downstairs. I'm like, man, y'all live underneath me? I never knew this. Like, I only moved here like a week or two. But I haven't. He's like, yeah, Justin's downstairs asleep. But like, you can go holler at him if you want. I was like, what? He moved back from Portland to Myrtle Beach? He's like, yeah, he just moved back like 2 or 3 days ago. I'm like, no fucking way. And then I go to Justin's, I'm like, Rizzo. And he's like fucking sleeping and shit with Charlie. I'm like, what are you doing, Grizzly? Like, who is that? It was fucking crazy, dude. I never expected that. I always thought it was about Portland. So anyway, I didn't go in his apartment. I was trying to deal with Terry.
Yeah.
And, but anyway, finally, Justin comes over and hangs out with me and shit. Like, I didn't have nothing to eat, that's what it was. I didn't have no food. And it was like a fucking 100-mile hike to get food. And he's like, you can go to my place and fix a sandwich, man. Like, dude, good night going over there, please. With your mom. Mom fucking hates me now. But man, I should do what she will fucking hate me. Are you sure, man? Like, I ain't fucking trying to start anything. I'm like, dude, come on. And so we go over there, and Jerry and Jimmy sitting there drinking, watching TV, and kind of break, you know, just break the ice with them. Like, what's up, Jerry? And like, hey, Jimmy. We're sitting there, or me and Justin go, he's showing me the room and shit. Maybe we go back out in the living room. Justin's like, yeah, Tasha's gonna fix a sandwich, she ain't got no food. Da da da. I don't know, I just break the ice with Jerry. I'm like, you ain't got no red Kool-Aid laying around, do you? You know, it's because she fucking laughed at it, too. It was a funny part. Even though red Kool-Aid laying around, do you? It's a weird family, man. I think a crazy story too, man. I guess Justin kind of felt like I abandoned him when I moved back to Mount Airy with Allison that first time I moved to Myrtle Beach with him. And, bullshit. Never kicked the door. I was gonna kick a door and left the fucking key on the microwave for him. That's Allison. I never kicked the fucking door in. Allison was with me the whole time. Fucking gay nigga probably kicked his own fucking door in. He's pissed off he wasn't getting no more money from me.
What happened?
I don't know, but like 2 weeks later Justin called me and was like, dude, did you kick the door in? I was like, kick the door in? I was like, what are you talking about? So yeah, Patrol said he came home and the door was kicked in. Like, I got Allison to vouch for him down there. Oh, no, no. Wait, no, no, I moved back to Myrtle Beach, like, I don't know, it was probably like 5-6 months later. But I didn't move back with the intention of staying with Justin, you know. I just moved back, you know. I stayed in a homeless shelter for 2 months. I lived with this drug dealing Cuban for a while. Like, that's when I finally decided to call Justin, hang out with him. It was around 2 years. Plus, I was fucking selling hash in Myrtle Beach. Very young, so you just might want to smoke some hash.
Right.
So, one night, I heard Justin's studio at Myrtle Beach Resort, and him and Sherry are living together. Apparently, Justin branded me as this bad guy to Sherry. All this shit. I guess I just told her that I kicked in Gay Trail's door and shit. How I left him hanging down there at the dude's house and whatnot. Which, that's not even the fucking case, dude. Fucking dude we live with was trying to fuck us anyway. And I was in a relationship with Allison somewhat. And, you know, it was just wrong timing, man. You know, fucking. But anyway, it was me, Sherry, and Justin. We were drinking, smoking hash. Fucking Cherry gets all fucking drunk. Starts popping off at the mouth about shit. Like, fucking calling me out. Like, pretty much calling me the biggest piece of shit ever. This and that. And the shit just fucking kept going on and on. And I fucking got aggravated as fuck at her. So I just fucking, I was wanting to throw something at her when she was sitting at the stove. So all I didn't have was a CD and I fucking threw it and went zooming by her head. I'm like, shut the fuck up, Cherry. All fucking bent out of shape and fucking get him the fuck out of here. Get him the fuck out of here now. So Justin pretty much said I had to leave because he didn't want shit to fucking be sour and get in trouble with his job, which I understood that. But where I lived in fucking Myrtle Beach, and he lived in Myrtle Beach, Detroit, it's like a fucking 10-mile walk. And it was already 2:30 in the morning. So I had to fucking walk all the way back to Myrtle Beach. It took me 3.5 fucking hours.
Oh my god.
And, that's fucking bullshit. I probably shouldn't have moved to CD of Sherry, but I sat there smoking my fucking hash with her and my fucking weed. And fucking, all she's doing is calling me a piece of shit, and how I fucked Justin over in this. I was like, I never fucked Justin over any. I was like, Justin, I came down here and I stayed with Justin, and I fucking paid my dues. Like, Justin, I started my job when moved in with Cheryl, he covered my part of the rent. So I got paid. And I fucking paid him back, you know? Fucking gave him the money he put in. And then Cheryl, as soon as I paid Justin back, Cheryl was asking us for more fucking money, man. I was like, dude, no. Like, there's three of us, and the fucking rent is paid for. I was like, we paid for a month, and it's been 2 weeks since we paid you. There's no reason why we should be giving you money another 2 weeks. A full month's rent. But that makes no sense. I told Justin, I was like, that's bullshit, dude. That makes no sense why he would be doing that. And then it's like, he's fucking trying to, like, not blackmail. He went out and bought, like, that gay black guy went out and bought a shitload of groceries. Me and Justin never asked him to buy groceries for us. But he did it anyway and held that over us, like, oh, I bought groceries for you. Dude, if you're going to buy groceries for us and expect something in return, you keep your fucking groceries. I work at a fucking restaurant. I get all the free food I fucking want.
Crazy.
And it was just a big fucked up situation, man. The fucking dude was trying to get over on us. And I know it. I saw it. I don't think Justin really saw it because he fucking liked the house. Plus, the room Justin had in, he fucking had fleas all in his room. And then,
turn it down, man!
Yeah, I know that fucking black dude. I ain't kicking his fucking door. Actually, when I fucking moved back to Myrtle Beach later on, this month later, I fucking went down to the house and the fucking door kicked in. The fucking same door was, wasn't nothing wrong with it.
Weird.
Well, it was people, man. People didn't say anything. Fucking, start shit, man. It was bullshit. I fucking hate it, man. That's why I don't like people, man. I hate people. I generally hate people, man.
Mm-hmm.
People are fucking conniving fucks. That's all they are. I mean, I can sit here and say, I've never been that way. I ain't that way anymore, but no reason why I'm kicking this fucking door. And, what reason would I have to kick it for, you know? Like, well, honestly, especially when I left the key laying on the fucking microwave.
He said that Allison broke up with you, like, the day after that. Like, she came down there and...
She didn't.
He said that, she came down there, convinced you to come back with her, and then, like, the next day she broke up with you.
No, she didn't break up with me. We broke up 300 times. That wouldn't give me a reason to kick it up. That wouldn't make me kick it up. Somebody else's. I even told Justin Portman, like, believe whatever the fuck you want to believe in. Like, obviously, you don't believe me, so you're going to believe what you want.
Yeah. It's crazy how reality gets warped in stories.
Oh, shit, man. I know. That's like I'm saying, man. People, if somebody breaks their fucking finger next week, by the time the story's stretched out, the fucking... laid out and over time they fucking went from breaking their fucking finger to fucking dying in a car accident.
Right.
Like it's something that's getting added to the story every day. Like there's something else added to it that I didn't even. I was like, what? What was this fucking dude? Oh, this is fucking funny. I got home from work one night and I was living with that guy. Yeah, me and Justin was white. We were the only white guys that lived there. And I forgot my key. That night. I knocked on the front door and nobody came to it. And man, I was like, where the fuck is Justin? I'm in control. And, I fucking go to the control's window because there's a light on and I was gonna knock on his window and I saw a white foot laying in his bed. I was like, what the fuck is Justin doing? I thought Justin was laying in the bed with this motherfucker. I was like, really? Like, no fucking way. Like, Cottrell came and opened the door. Like, who's in your room with you? Oh, that's one of my lovers. No, it ain't Justin, is it? Like, no, it's not Justin. No, it ain't Justin. I'm like, oh, okay, man. Just making sure, man. It's all white foot. the dude that he was with, man, he was a fucking ecstasy dealer and shit. He's fucking shitty, motherfucker. Dude. Yeah, I don't know, man. That fucking black dude, he's a shitty fucker. All in all, for the money we gave the dude to begin with, me and Justin, or Justin first gave him $650.
Yeah.
The rent was not $900 a month for everything. And Justin gave him, yeah, I think it was exactly $600 because it was like $300 a piece. And then this dude turns right around like 2 weeks later and expects $300 more from both of them. And I'm like, fuck no, dude. That's not how that shit works. I pay you $300, I'm good for a fucking month. I ain't good for 2 weeks, I'm good for a fucking month. I'm not a rent worth, bitch. I told Justin before even Allison came down there, dude, I was like, this is bullshit, dude. I was like, I'm not giving them fucking money. I was like, you're going to tell him, I was like, I'll go get a motel room. At that time, too, man, I was like, fuck it, there's motel rooms on my way to my job. So when they were shit, you know, holding the wall, I was like, fuck it, I wasn't there. I was like, how much y'all charge about a week? And I don't know, like, wow, now it is. These, and we charge $250, no, it was more than $350 a week. I was like, oh, well, fuck that idea. But I wasn't going to sit there and let some fucking gay black guy fuck me over on my I told Justin, I was like, dude, hey, you're stupid if you stay here, man. Well, he had a better deal just staying at Myrtle Beach Resort, honestly.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, yeah, that's right. He couldn't stay there because of the season. That's right.
Crazy.
Me and Justin have been through a lot of shit together. Some good shit, bad shit. Fucking crazy stuff, man. Fistfights, been in fights with black people at strip clubs in Portland.
Yeah.
We went to the Pink Pony one time at Myrtle Beach. It was like first night I moved down there. First time I've been in a strip club. I just go balls deep out, dude. I just fucking get drunk, buying lap dances. I had a little too many Jim Beams. And fucking goddamn strip club started spinning on me. Like, just all right, I'm gonna call a cab. I'm gonna go wait for it outside, man. I was like, I can't take it in there, it's too hot. And when I got there, I called a cab. I don't know how I called a cab, but I called it. And I'm sitting up there in the sidewalk, fucking puking. I'm at the strip club. And Justin comes out looking for me, and he fucking almost walks into my puke with his flip flops. He's like, what the hell? He's like, you're out here puking? I was like, dude, I'm fucking drunk. He said Allison broke up with me 2 days later, so she pretty much already broke up. You're just kind of like, I don't know what you'd call it. They're still friends, but I'm out of here. That's not the reason why I fucking left Myrtle Beach. I was getting drunk way too much. I was withdrawn on uppers. Allison's bullshit. I guess it's part of somewhat Allison. But plus, man, I mean, I really wanted to make it work with her, man. I love her, dude. I ain't bust on that like that since, fucking Teresa Davis in high school. I did this one girl from elementary school all the way up to high school. I fucking broke up with her in high school at the swimming pool because I just wanted to finger this one girl. Dumbest thing I ever did. I probably could have honestly been with her for the rest of my life. Or, I probably could have married her. But it was stupid. I broke up with her just to finger this fucking girl. In the fucking swimming pool. Didn't even fuck her, just to finger her.
When was the last time you saw Justin?
That last time I was at Myrtle Beach. I lost the keys in the car.
Oh yeah, when your mom.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Sorry, my mic is fucking on. I just pretty much laid it on the table for Justin, that message. I'm like, dude, my friendship's based on $20, and I guess that's the way it's pretty much going to be. And I told him, I pretty much said, I was like, I don't want to lose a friend because of $20.
Right.
I mean, if I can overlook $650, I don't know why I can't overlook paying $20, man. Ridiculous if you ask me. He's got other reasons.
Is that a message on the phone or what?
No, it's on Facebook. Right? I try to call his phone, he don't answer. He'll ring twice and he'll fucking hit ignore or whatever. It's all good though. There's no sleep. It's kind of a shitty thing to say, but if it isn't, then. Playing this game this whole time without the sound of the game.
Me too.
It's weird. I don't even really give a fuck about this game. I'm trying not to get mad at this game anymore. It's pretty silly that I get mad about it. I'm a lot better until I'm 5 though. I think a part of me though, man, I'm fucking. I was really addicted to playing this for a while, like the Xbox, but now I'm finally getting to the point of like being 28. And I gotta fucking stop playing video games so much. Fucking do something with my life other than sit here and fucking drink Monster Energy drinks and worry about what the fuck my ranking is on a fucking video game. Fucking stop knifing me, piece of shit. Damn, I've gotten knifed like 4 times in a row by this dude. You ain't knifing me this time, bitch. Fucking ballistic knife.
Oh shit, I'm gonna call it a night after this one.
John, too, I'm gonna go watch this stuff from a documentary.
You gonna
eat some popcorn.
You working tomorrow?
Yeah, I gotta work tomorrow.
You make more money on Fridays or weekends or what?
Not really. There's a lot of drivers, but we'll see what happens. I'll probably make more money than I did in the last 2 nights, but who knows? Probably not. It's fucking pretty crappy out there now. Looks like tonight, man. It's fucking dead as fuck, and they had like 5 drivers on. You don't need 5 drivers, man.
Right.
Like, and then last night, we had 6, and it was fucking. I didn't get a delivery for like 2 hours, man. I was like, why do we have so many drivers? I mean, I feel like I can do really well at delivering pizzas. I mean, I guess it's because I know the man. I mean, I hurry pretty well, but. I don't know, it's just fucking, I feel like people are incompetent there. I'm like, dude. One night, I delivered 4 deliveries in less than 40 minutes. 2 of my deliveries were to Red Bush Road. And that's not taking both at the same time. I was taking one at a time. Like, I took one to Red Bush Road, then I took one up to North Main Street. And I think I had one at the Hampton Inn beside Papa John's. And I had another one on Red Brush, or near Red Brush. I fucking did all that in like 40 minutes. Maybe some drivers, they fucking pull shit around. A lot of drivers like to smoke weed while they're on the job, right? I'll do it every once in a while, but man, I don't do it anymore because I'm trying to have my wreck, man. I can't afford that shit. Just thank God that day I did get that wreck, I wouldn't fucking smoke.
Passing out. I think I'm gonna call it a night, man.
No.
It was good to hear from you.
Always.
I'll talk to you next time, bro.
Word up. I'll be on tomorrow night.